Finding the face value of a discounted note. Let's look at an example where a person needs to borrow $5,800 to pay for home improvements. The question is asking, would a simple discount note with a face value of $5,800 meet their needs? Let's take a look at how discount notes are calculated or operate. The face value or maturity value of $5,800 has a discount rate in this example of a little less than 6%. The term is 180 days. If we calculate the bank discount, this is the charge for the use of the money. Because it's a discount note, that bank discount is subtracted from the face value, which means this individual during the 180 days only has the proceed amount, which is $166.75, less than what they intended to borrow. So how do we compute the face value to get the achieved amount of proceeds that we need? We're going to use the following formula, where P is the proceeds received by the borrower. This is where we would put the amount that we actually want. D is our bank discount rate, and T is the time of the loan in years. So in our example that we started out with, what would that amount be for the proceeds? Our desire here is to have proceeds of the needed $5,800 for the home improvement. We replace the rest of the variables with the given information. Our discount rate is at 5.75%, expressing that as a decimal, and time in years, this is a 180 day loan. To calculate this, we can either simplify the denominator and then take the numerator divided by the denominator, or if we want to put this all in our calculator in one operation, we would have to put the numerator $5,800 divided by and then put parentheses around the expression in the denominator and then hit our equals. This is going to give us our maturity value. This is what the individual would have to ask for, the face value for this discounted loan, so that in fact they would come away with the proceeds or the amount of money that they needed for their home improvements. It's a higher amount, so when you calculate your bank discount, you can see it's higher than when the original question was asking for the $5,800, but it achieves the amount of money that they were in need of. Let's look at another example here. Benson Automotive needs $120,000 to upgrade shop tools. The discount note has a 9.5% rate and matures in 80 days. They're asking us to find the face value of the loan. Because this is a discount note and they need $120,000, this amount is acting as our proceeds. So we're going to have to ask for a larger amount because the interest or bank discount is subtracted from that amount, and we want to, or at least this automotive dealership needs the $120,000. So here is our formula for calculating the maturity value of a discount note. We will put $120,000 in place of the proceeds, the desired amount, in the denominator 1 minus D, which is the discount rate of 9.5% expressed as a decimal, times time expressed in terms of years. Simplifying the denominator, we see the following, and now we're left with the numerator, 120,000 divided by the value in the denominator, giving us the mature value or the face value of this discount note. This would be the amount Benson Automotive would need to ask for so that they had proceeds of the desired $120,000. Another way to simplify this formula, again, if you want to do this all in one step, would be to put the parentheses around the quantity that's in the denominator, starting with 120,000 divided by parentheses and the following should result in that maturity value. Another example, we have a Japanese electric company requires proceeds of $720,000 and borrows from a bank in Thailand at 12% discount for 45 days. Couple key words here that tells us this is a discount note. They want proceeds of $720,000 and it has a discount rate of 12%. And so we're in the same situation. We need to ask for, or this company needs to ask for a greater amount so that they have the proceeds equal to the amount that they're needed. So they're asking us to calculate the face value. We'll use our formula to calculate the face value, plugging in the information given. The proceeds or the desired amount needed for this company is in the numerator, in the denominator 1 minus D, which is our interest rate of 12% as a decimal times our time expressed in a year. Simplifying the denominator and then taking the numerator divided by the value in the denominator gives us the face value or maturity value of a discounted note. This company would have to go in requesting a maturity value of over $730,000 so that they achieve the amount of cash once the note was discounted to meet their financial needs. Again, in this problem, you can put the parentheses around the quantity in the denominator to do this in one calculation.